Hey guys, welcome to Killer 7 on the GameCube. Also available on the PS2, but we're gonna give the GameCube version a run. It has a lot better load times, so I prefer this version. Anyways, this game is absolutely crazy, so be prepared, viewers. Holy hell, I don't think you can be prepared. I'm not prepared. This game, one of my most favorite games of all time, and I haven't beaten it in a few years, so I definitely want to give a proper run through here. Bring you guys along with me. As soon as I hit this button, get ready. You're gonna be hearing that laugh quite a bit. Oh my goodness, normal or deadly? Deadly is a real bad motherfucker mode, so yeah, we're not gonna mess with that at all. Oh, get ready to also experience the wonderful music in this game. There's literally not one thing about this game I can honestly complain about, personally, and I know opinions greatly vary when it comes to this game, but I think it's an absolute masterpiece, and I am so freaking excited about this. We're just gonna jump on in. I'll try and explain things as we go. But it's kind of just balls to the wall crazy, and honestly, I'm not going to be able to explain this to you guys really at all. It's a complete mindfuck of a game. Like, oh god, we need to start the level here. What did I say? A target 00 angel. Okay. As soon as we start the level, we got this silhouette here. We take a shot. And there we go. We're starting it off. Oh man, I should put a little disclaimer here. This series is going to be the most violent and extreme thing you probably see on this channel ever, honestly. Extremely graphic. Not only is there harsh language, but the blood and gore, it rivals like a Tarantino movie, if not worse, honestly. Alrighty, let's go ahead and shut up, get started here. That would be Garcian Smith. He is our main protagonist of the game. We're going to be playing as him quite a bit. Well, hopefully not too much. And who is this shady looking character over here? Well, let's wait and find out. This game is going to leave you guys fucking stumped and amazed, I promise. Well, Christopher Mills. Okay, interesting. Looks like he handed us something. I love this art style too. Oh, I just have this huge nerd boner for this game, honestly. I could just go on and on about it. I'm really going to try and contain it for you guys, but it might just come out of my pants every now and then, honestly. Ooh.
It's me. So, you there yet?
You mean this shit hole?
That's where they all hang out. Our information tells us that there's 14 of them.
And they're all fun.
Nah, keep one alive so we can ask who the boss is.
Anything else I should know?
Nah, not really. You'll know when you see them, they're, different.
Will do.
Well, may the Lord smile.
And the devil have mercy.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, here we go. Assignment 33. Destroy the Heaven Smile headquarters and capture the chief alive. Alrighty, wonderful. I hope you guys are ready. Haven't even told you what kind of game this is yet, honestly. No, we don't need help, Bungie Cord Man. Alright, off we go. So this game is a shooter. It's an on-rail shooter. I basically can move forward and backwards like so, and I'm always on a rail. I can't actually explore a room that I'm in besides, you know, looking around on this path. I can go into a first-person mode where I can shoot enemies like so. Just like that. Reload. And that's pretty much the gist of it. We're just going to move on here in front of this security camera. It's going to be weird because that little transition noise is actually my ringtone, so I'm going to keep thinking my phone is going off. And... eh? What is this? Oh yes, we're gonna transform into one of the baddest motherfuckers in all of video game history.
You don't wanna go any further. It's dangerous. My friends are all dead. They were all murdered by people that look like this. I have been chosen.
That is a heaven smile. It's a dead heaven smile.
Oh, shit. There's more than 14. Those bastards are breeding.
And this here is Dan Smith. Oh my gosh, I fucking love Dan Smith. We're probably going to be using him most of the game. Well, there's another character I really like to use, and yeah, he uses a revolver. Oh my god, it's a badass revolver too. Oh hey, who's this guy? Check it out, Iwazaru. Alright, how are you doing, sir? Oh yes, let the bloodbath begin. So I was quiet for that conversation just because I wanted you guys to be able to hear the voice acting for some of the NPCs in the game. Most of them, the Remnant Psyches as they're called, actually talk like that where you can't actually understand what they're saying and you need to read the subtitles. So I'm not going to hesitate to talk over it if need be, which probably will be most of the time. This is a save room. We can go in here and save. We can use the TV. We're not going to mess with that yet, and if we go to the other side of the room, we can get some nice tutorials from Iwazaru. He's going to be steering us around through most of the game, giving us tips and all that good shit. But for now, we don't need to mess with any of that. We're just going to move on. Oh, I should also talk about the start menu too. There's so much to explain. It's just absolutely crazy. This game has a huge amount of depth. In fact, it has like a plot analysis FAQ on GameFAQs. That's about 133 pages long, if I'm not mistaken. Incredibly in-depth, this game. Okay, so if I hit start, we have the Smiths. We can actually transform into a multitude of characters here. Right now, we can only be Dan, Kaede, Coyote, and Khan. I may slip into calling her Katie, just because it's easier for me to say, but I believe the correct pronunciation is Kaede. I can barely say it. Yeah, these guys are all bad motherfuckers. And then we have items. Nothing really going on here. We have our target. If we look at our photo here. Who we were going for. At the bottom right, we have our blood levels. We don't need to worry about that yet. Memos, we don't have any notes. And at the top right of the screen, you can see our health. Or actually, it's at the top left now. When that eyeball starts to close, we're taking a lot of damage. Ooh, and that means we're about to die. You need to keep an ear out. Keep an ear open. For a laughter. Whenever you hear laughter, that means one of these heaven smiles is going to come towards you. Whenever you see that little DNA looking thing, you need to shoot that. That's the critical hit spot. You can kill them by just shooting them regularly in just random locations. However, you're really going to want to hit those critical hit spots. You'll get more blood for it, and it's just, it behooves you to do so. The blood is used to, like, level up your characters. Tight and out of sight. And, you also get thin blood, which you can use for like various character abilities and also healing yourself if you take damage. So yeah, you really want to get blood. Shudder to think. Yeah, heaven smiles. Oh my goodness. So heaven smiles are creatures that only we can see. We have to scan them with the left trigger, which I did for that guy. And once you scan them, you get full visibility of them and you can see their critical hit spots. If you don't scan them, you can't see them. So that's why you got to keep an ear out. Like so. You gotta make sure you know when they're coming for you. Let's see if I can't. Oh, it's a little tricky to get their arms. Yeah, because you easily dismember them like so. And if you actually take down the critical hit spot, or rather destroy the limb that it's on, you can't kill them in one shot, so you gotta do it that way. Alrighty, not too bad, not too bad. Let's just move on here. And here's another Remnant Psyche for us. This here is Travis. What do you got going on here, Travis? Travis is amazing. He always has a different shirt off, or a shirt on. Every time you talk to him, the chief killed me. Oh, yeah, I guess I did forget. Travis. All right, what's going on here, buddy? Eh, a little bit. He's not going to let us take the elevator. What a dick. All right, let's go this way then. And yeah, I also need to explain how the rails are working. So we hold A to, like, move forward. And whenever we reach a branching path or character, we just have to tilt the stick in the right direction while holding A. So, like, hold left there. And Iwazaru has even more shit that he wants to tell us about. We're in a tight spot. Okay. Who is that up there? You see the guy hanging from the ceiling there? Trusted companion Kikazaru. Okay. I know this is like making no sense to you guys. You just have to roll with it for now. Trust me, it's still not going to make sense after you beat it, but it will a little bit more. So we're looking for bullets, okay? And Kikazaru is going to help us find said bullets. Bullets of the soul. Ah, yes, the soul shells. In the name of Harmon. Okay. Off you go, buddy. Hey there, how's it going? Nope, always disappears whenever you approach him. Into the parking lot we go. Oh, man. This gets a little crazy here already. It's a nice little setup here for beginners. Oh, we get a new type of smile, too. This is a camellia smile. Camellia, I guess Iwazar is going to explain it, but basically, whenever you approach a camellia smile, she runs away like a crazy bastard and explodes, and basically depriving you of any blood that it may drop. It drops a tremendous amount of blood if you're able to actually critical hit one, which is really cool. The Hellion, we hold the R button and press Y 3 times. We can shoot out a crazy powerful shot called Collateral Shot. Dan is also known as the Hellion. It can be a little confusing for newbies there. And a lot of characters have different abilities that you can charge up with the Y button while you're aiming. Coyote Smith can charge up. Mask de Smith can as well. I'm thinking of any others off the top of my head. No, not really. Oh my god, Khan. Dan and Khan are the ones I use the most, and we'll explain all these a little bit more later. For now, we have this camellia to deal with. Now, she is way the fuck over there, and if I approach her, she's gonna run away. Yeah, you see that there in the background, viewers? Ooh, there's something back there invisible. So what I'm gonna do is show off a different character. Katie. Her name's Katie now. I've changed it. Her ability is, not only is she a badass, of course they're all badass, but her gun actually has a scope on it. You hit Y and you can zoom in. And we may get lucky here, let's see. Otherwise, if I don't critical hit this thing, I'm just gonna panic shoot, so get ready. And the waver on Katie is kinda crazy. Oh shit, nope. Okay, so we're not gonna get as much blood, not near as much blood. However, we're still gonna get a little bit, so I guess it's all right. And the reason Iwazaru was telling us about the collateral shot that Dan can use is because there is this thing here. That is a spawner. It's going to continually shoot out eggs for us, and we need to basically do a ton of damage to that yellow spot there. For now, we're going to switch back to Daniel and get ready, because we don't actually have enough blood to critical hit this thing yet. We need at least 3 vials, and if you look at the status on the left right here, oh god, we have 8. Never mind. Holy shit. So I could farm up a little bit here, but I don't think they really give an amount of blood that's really necessary for you to grind off of. Just die. I can't hit that from here. Just die. Charge up a collateral shot. Charge it up 3 times. And then shoot it off. Holy hell. It shoots up a bright beam of energy that, again, does tremendous damage. That was a little close there. Okay. Let's reload and press on now that we've got that spawner out of here. And we gotta talk to Travis again. Alright, what's going on? Oh, he's a bad girl now. I want that shirt. That's amazing. An egg-laying heaven smile, huh? Okay, fair enough. So now the heaven smiles have made their own spawners. Remember, we expected to only encounter like 14 when we came in here. And now they have fucking spawners, so... Oh, yeah, what's up, dude? Yep, that is the reason the Smith Syndicate is around, if I'm not mistaken, to kill the Heaven Smiles. Alright, we gotta take down the Queen, apparently. The Gatekeeper is in charge of the Queen. Interesting. Okay, remember, there's a bullet around here somewhere, and speak of the devil. There it is, so we're just going to point this direction here and grab it. This is a soul shell. You find these in essentially every level, if I'm not mistaken, and you have to collect a certain amount of these to get past the Gatekeeper. The Gatekeeper blocks the way for you to basically complete the level and fight a boss. So, keep an eye out for soul shells, viewers. Okay. Keep an eye out for Kikazaru. Keep an eye out for Dan kicking some ass. God, this guy's crazy good. Okay. He's all around well-rounded. I gotta remember that if I'm talking too much, I'm not going to be able to hear these guys. I need to turn my volume up. Ooh, that was a lucky shot. Okay, not bad. And when we amass a certain amount of blood, we can only carry around 1,000 blood, or thick blood, that is. And when we have 1,000, We need to get to a Harmon's room immediately. In fact, we need to do so beforehand, ideally, because he can't carry more than 1,000. And again, I mentioned that that blood is used to level up, and we're going to want as much stats as possible, as much stat gains as possible. Life is precious. Okay, what's going on? I think he's going to explain the life gauge here, which I already briefly touched. There's nothing. Yeah, I would agree with that. It's kind of a weird name. Okay, totally pointless. Moving on to the second floor. You can tell whenever that particular music is playing that you're not actually going to encounter any Heaven Smiles. There's a lot of little tricks you get or you learn while you're playing that game. Someone just yelled, "Help me!" We're going to turn this corner. Oh, shit. So, again, to everyone else in existence, these guys are damn near invisible. They appear as these weird, just transparent forms you can barely see. And if they catch up to you, they will just fuck your world. This is actually a situation I don't want to be in right now. So let's just drill this guy. Yes, okay. He's Gonzo. And his friend exploded for no apparent reason. Alright, fair enough. So, yeah, two over there. I thought about switching to Katie, but it's not gonna happen. Can I tag you from... Ah, fuck me, right? These leg shots, dude. And come on, bam! No, I crippled them both. The blood is not going well here. I can also hit the B button to just immediately lock onto guys. Helps a lot when they're crawling at you like fucking scary little zombies. Oof. So, yo. Is that his head still laying on the ground? Oh. Like I said, this game is incredibly violent and pretty damn scary, honestly. And this game will also fuck your mind up. Like, really, it's a huge psychological fuck you, and it's something that Suda does so well. Ooh. Anyways, we're in another room here. Ooh, it's a new type of smile. That is a micro smile. Those guys are super fast, and they charge at you with incredible speed. However, goddamn. They don't actually hurt you if they connect with you, meaning if he runs into me, what he does is he actually just blinds me temporarily, and this is sucking dick. I am taking down way too many limbs, not getting much blood here. So I usually like to switch to another smith right now, one that shoots a lot faster. However, we'll try it with Daniel. Nice, we got him, okay. And this is where I got, there's a video on my channel like before I started doing Let's Plays. I actually posted a video saying my Killer 7 explanation, I think is what it's named. And this is honestly what I tell myself so I can sleep at night when I try to understand this fucking game. Quote from Travis here. Alright, their target, the very dignity. I hope you're reading this and keeping up, because I'm going to need one of you to explain everything to me. Oh, which reminds me. Yeah, why should you understand the meaning? You're just a fucking killer, basically, is what I tell myself when I play this game. Which reminds me. It's going to be inevitable that you're going to see, or rather, you're going to want to maybe post spoilers in the comments, and you're probably going to see them. Oh my god, aim. Aim, Alan. Oh shit. If you take down the head, you can still critical hit them, like in the bottom of their neck, but it's a little bit difficult. But anyways, all that I ask, because I know spoilers, I just heard a woman scream, are inevitable, is just like maybe put spoilers in giant caps or something so people can skim over them and not read them.
You gotta help me.
That would be nice. Okay. And, oh! She dead. Her, she's missing half of a body. Holy lord, this game. Okay, moving on. Let's go ahead, and we can't go this way quite yet. This door is actually locked, so we're gonna go this direction. And I heard a laugh. Okay, definitely gonna need to turn the volume up. There's also a remnant psyche over here to our left. God damn it, Daniel. Am I gonna have to swap you out already, you piece of garbage? Oh, I'm sorry, Dan. I love you. I love you still. This guy here is Yoon Hyun, and he carries a mask around. He's kind of an asshole, and I don't necessarily think I'm going to show it off. Maybe I'll do it here. Yeah, I guess I'll do it here. Why not? Alright, yeah, getting a little bit of backstory here. Fair enough. See, he seems nice and polite right now. That's pretty nice. Okay. I would like that, actually, if you don't mind. Basically, this game has... I checked the candlesticks. This game has a lot of puzzles in it as well. It is hidden here, okay. And if you have a hard time, or you're having a hard time figuring out where to go, you can actually talk to this guy, and he'll help you out. But you do have to pay him a little bit of blood, and to pay him blood, you actually have to shoot his mask and then talk to him again. The mask will tell you. So yeah, it's basically the game's way of saying, hey, you can get a hint, but you gotta pay for it. The mask lusts for blood. How much thick blood does it cost, anyway? Yeah, and it's not thin blood either, it's your precious thick blood. Speaking of which, you can't actually grind Heaven Smiles. You can only get a certain amount of thick blood per level. So, yeah, that's something to think about, because the Heaven Smiles do infinitely respawn. If we shoot his mask, where'd you go? There you go. Check this out. Eh, I can't see you from here. He changes to this guy, who's now wearing the mask and flipping us off because we can't solve basic puzzles, apparently. Oh, he's taking it all. How much did he grab? I didn't check my blood levels before. Yeah, I'm the loser. I'm sorry. The true mask. All right. I shall guide you. What's going on, buddy? The Ring of Fire. And remember to show you that on the candlesticks. Oh, yes. So there's a room right next to us, and it's full of candlesticks that aren't lit. We need to get a thing called the Ring of Fire, and then light the candlesticks in the Tomorrow It Could Be You. I forgot about that quote. I actually really like that quote. Oh, that's awesome. We're not going to go in the room yet. Totally pointless because we don't have a Ring of Fire. But yeah, we need to light them in the correct order to solve a puzzle. It's actually incredibly easy to figure out, but I figured I'd do that anyway. Hello? Huh? What are you talking about? Everything is transparent. What is this guy's name? Kes Bloody Sunday or something like that? Yeah, I think that's his name. Something weird. Another remnant psyche to try and give us some hints. His hints come into play a lot later in the levels. Right now he's just kind of random and you're meeting characters. So don't worry about it, viewers. Trust me, nothing to worry about here. And I need to wrap this thing up. I get really carried away with this game. Some of the episodes may be a little long because I tend to forget things. I tend to get absorbed in this fucking beautiful game. A major tight spot. What's going on, Ibizarro? Huh? Oh, no. Not him. Eh? I can't kill him. Are you kidding me? No. The audio isn't unsynced or desynced. I just knew what he was going to say because I've played this first level way too much. An incorrigible fool. Nice. Oh, yeah, I appreciate the confidence, Ibizarro. Yeah, seriously. Easy. That meal's really full. In the name of the... Oh, wow. So that's how it's going to be? All right, fair enough. Screw you too, buddy. We're almost done. One more thing we need to grab while we're in the general area is you can find carrier pigeons in the levels like so. These have some little backstory for you. Not necessary to complete the level at all. If you feel like reading this, feel free to now. I'm not going to read it out loud for you unless you guys really want me to, but this is Johnny Gagnon. And what do you want with us? Dear Amir, he says at the beginning. This Amir character? Not too sure. Okay. You get excited when you slow. Okay. A little weird. Watch them like a hawk. Alright. Oh, yes. He was sent to investigate the Smith Syndicate. He's going to tell us a little bit about each and every one. There's Dan, who uses a revolver. Katie uses an automatic rifle. Okay. Khan is amazing. He uses two full auto pistols. And Masked Smith has fucking grenade launchers. And Kevin actually throws knives. He's the only one of the Smiths who doesn't use a gun. Coyote is a bitch and no one likes him. And Garcian uses a small silenced pistol. He's a giant black man. He does not need to compensate. Rest assured. No, I'm not like making a joke. He actually is incredibly tall. If you switch to him, he's like towers over the fucking Heaven Smiles. It's pretty funny. Okay. And we'll be contacting us again. Okay, thank you, Mr. Gagnon, for giving us a little bit of backstory. And no, Coyote really isn't that bad. He has a nice little revolver. He's a thief, so he can, like, pick locks and shit. And it's pretty nice. We have a lot of explaining to do. But for now, we need to go into Harmon's room. And I need to get rid of all of this thick blood and actually save my game. And hey, you are someone different, aren't you? And I actually can't save my game in here. Certain Harmon's room, you actually can't save the game. Anyways, we go to the TV. From here, we can exchange our thick blood and turn them into serums. If I mash the A button, it actually goes a little bit faster, so I'm going to do that. Hopefully the mic won't pick it up too loud. As you can see, I'm getting serums on the bottom. Now we can switch over to our characters. Garcian. Garcian, we can only change into in a Harmon's room. You cannot change it to him out in the field at all. And if you're playing as Garcian, you can't change into any of these other personas here. Just something to think about. We're actually going to level up Dan a little bit. So it starts off, he's at level 0 on everything. It just takes one little thing of serum. He gets down attack. You'll get different abilities depending on the amount that you level up. Down attack is sometimes when an enemy's down in front of him and you shoot down, he'll like instantly kill it. Also, another function of this TV is that characters will be locked at the beginning of a round or a level. You may have saw that some of them were grayed out when I was showing it off earlier. Wow, look at the vitality on Master Smith. And you can unlock personas here if you kill a certain amount of Heaven Smiles. Eventually, though, they will all unlock for you, as you see here. Oh my goodness. So much to explain. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial of Killer 7. There'll be a lot less explaining and a lot more craziness tomorrow, rest assured. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time.